imagine someone walking into a hospital ER and they're doubled over in pain, tears flowing from their eyes. A nurse notices and she springs into action and she immediately starts asking them questions to fill out an intake questionnaire, a brief intake questionnaire. And then afterwards, she starts asking more detailed questions to assess what exactly is the problem. You know, where does it hurt? What happened? When did it start? So the person gathers themselves and, you know, lifting up their hand and then lifting up their pinky finger, it reveals a very horrible paper cut. So confused and very annoyed, the nurse quickly responds by providing a band-aid, and then of course, routing them back home, telling them, get out of my ER. Why would you go to an ER with a paper cut? And then she turns her attention and rushes off to help somebody else, a victim of a very terrible rock climbing accident. In this case, rock beats paper. So this nurse is doing triage. What she's doing is she's figuring out who needs help as a priority based on a mix of observed symptoms, patient history, and domain-specific knowledge. And she's actually helping patients as much as she can in order to avoid using up valuable physician time and hospital resources. So the question is, what if we could automate this process? And this brings us to the world of triage AI agents. So the word triage is actually a French word. It means the action of picking or sorting. And the modern concepts of the word started around 1800 in military medicine, where the surgeon in chief of Napoleon's Imperial Guard introduced the concept of sorting battlefield injuries so that the most critical cases got care first, regardless of rank or class. But triage isn't just a hospital thing. If you've ever called 911 or gone to an auto mechanic or worked with customer service reps, you've been triaged. Insurance companies and cybersecurity systems triage cases into different priority levels according to risk classification. So the applications are innumerable. Triage AI agents imitate the way we humans do triage by automating this process of intake, intelligent prioritization, and routing using two calling agents working together in a multi-agentic system. And every triage AI agent has three essential components. Corresponding to the process our nurse followed earlier, intake. The first one is our intake agent. Here, the LLM is connected to knowledge. So we have our LLM, and typically through our MCP, we're connecting to various knowledge sources. And these knowledge sources could include things like client data, or it could include ticket data, depending on the use case. And for sure, it should include things like questionnaire templates. The intake agent's goal is to converse and collect data that can be passed on to the subsequent agents. Next, you have, typically, your assessment agent. Now, the assessment agent's goal is to do research and problem diagnosis in order to generate a detailed needs assessment along with a priority. And this agent consists of an LLM, and he's typically similar to more like a search agent, where he's connected to various domain-specific knowledge or search APIs, or even web search. And then finally, we have here, last but not least, our routing agent. Now, the goal of the routing and our action agent consists of an LLM corresponding to any number of APIs or services for completing or routing a request. It could be communication services like email. So let's do APIs, and it could be numerous. Email, SMS, or maybe it could be APIs for updating resources. It will also typically include access to the full list of triage cases in order to set and update the relative priorities of all the cases, including the one that it received from the assessment agent. Notice here that Triage AI agents aren't just chatbots or even conversational AI agents with RAG. While conversational AI agents can form part of the Triage AI agent system, that's about as far as the similarities go. They differ in their primary function, the workflow they follow, their adaptability, their decision making, and the use cases that they're best suited for. Triage AI agents can bring speed, consistency, and scalability to the human art of intelligent prioritization and routing. So if you're a developer or data scientist, this is a space worth exploring, starting with your favorite multi-agentic open source framework like LangFlow or LangChain or CrewAI. Because as more systems go AI native, triage isn't just something nurses will do, it's something we'll see integrated across the fabric of our digital workflows.